All right. It's all good. Let's see what this is here. Ba-da-bum. Okay. Let's see what's going on here for viewers. There we go. Hey, everybody. Hey, everybody.
Gentlemen, set the seats.
I'm Dan. I love your car.
Oh, really?
I don't think that would be the same kind of accolades.
I got a Honda Accord.
Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Welcome. Live from Stony Point, New York. We're here. What time is it?
10 to 7.
Beautiful.
You want me on this chair?
Wherever you want, you can.
Ouch.
How is it?
It's great. It's going to be a little tight if more than one of you is in the frame. Can I make it? Can I? Interesting. Okay. Well, let's see who's here.
Shabbat Shalom, gam yachad.
All right, how about, I'm referencing this siddur, but you probably don't agree with it. Let's do it on page 7. Let's sing Mayaf Ve'ayom, Shabbat Shalom.
They can't hear you. Shabbat Shalom. It said okay. Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom. Tucson Jim, because I'm sitting right beside, it sounds like it's in a tunnel.
Probably.
It's the room. We're in the meditation hut here at the Stony Point Retreat Center.
How about this one? Let me see. I'll wait another 2 minutes, 2 minutes for everybody to get here. How about,
Do you know how to, respond on Facebook? Can I respond on that?
You just talk to
them. Oh.
Yeah.
Hi, everybody.
Just talk to the Facebook.
Hi, Rabbi Jeffrey.
Excuse me. Let me tune up. That's always fun. So. Any good jokes?
Anibal and Matthew are messing around with the baby. Cute little baby.
Sorry.
Why don't we just put this beside you, then I can hear you and see the group. What, the Sim Shalom gives you a lot of songs?
The little book, yeah. Shabbat Shalom. Hey, Carol, if you put the thermostat down 2 degrees, it'll cool off.
Okay.
Hey, Jay. The
it's easy.
No, no, it's easy. It goes, that's it. I know you can hear it. Is that all right with you?
Wow,
that was so good. We move on. Next song. That's my melody, but you see, it's such a great melody, because everybody clapped at the right time. How about, let's use the Yisbuchu Hashemayim. It's right there on page 9. 6 lines from the bottom. You have to do that with your congregation, by the way. You have to tell them, 6 lines from the bottom.
But what are we singing?
Yisbuchu Hashemayim.
Okay. Shamayim, Hashemayim.
Thank you. going to continue with the Lecha Dodi. What melody do you like for Lecha Dodi? Any particular one? I'm you're the guest, so I'm just asking. Let's do this one. You can be seated now, because we don't want you to get tired.
And there's plenty of seats here, wherever.
Is that right? All right.
Sandy.
Hey, JT. Oh, how are they doing online?
Wonderful.
Yeah, a lot of rabbis, a lot of, yeah, they are.
Not easy, let me tell you. All right, let us continue with Chatzi Kaddish, page 20. They've got Chatzi Kaddish. Yid Gadah, Yid Gadah Shemei
Rabbah
Be'am Adi Rabbi Utei Amin Ramad Utei
Thank you.
I can stand too, then that's the way it works. So, Shabbat Shalom! I got you up a little early. It's okay. Just stand for a minute. I have a few words to say, and then we're going to do a little meditation. And that's going to be really, he's going to love this meditation. Where are you going? You got my phone. So, Shabbat Shalom, rabbinical candidates, all of our Aleph friends, our relatives, people who support our rabbinical candidates, welcome, Shabbat Shalom. My name is Rabbi Stephen Bland. I'm the founder and the dean of JSLI, the Jewish Spiritual Leaders Institute, and also the world's only, fully online, Jewish Universalist Synagogue, Sim Shalom. And in fact, the world is watching right now, in addition to all of you. So it's a great pleasure to welcome you all formally for this 13th JSLI Rabbinical Ordination Weekend. Don't cringe at 13, okay? 13 is, for Jews, it's a good number. When a Jewish boy comes of age at 13, or a girl, at 12 actually, but 13 is good, a kid becomes a bar, a b'nai mitzvah. So that's good, about 13. Rambam, Maimonides, states that the number 13 represents the number of principles of Jewish faith. And in Gematria, science of numbers, which I don't really like, but I do it. If you add up 13, it comes out to Ahava. Don't do it in your head. I'll pay above there. Or Echad equals 13. So it's all good, right? So I'd like to welcome the two additional rabbis who are here with the Beit Din for me. First let me start Rabbi Tunick. All right. Rabbi Tunick is from Nashville. She's going to do a set right after I want to do it. She's a cantorial soloist and a composer. She's a rabbi. She's served congregations in Philadelphia, in Meridian, Mississippi, where there are no congregations anymore. No, not there. Jacksonville, Florida, and she's currently rabbi and cantor for Temple B'nai Israel in Florence. She was ordained in July 2013 as part of the sixth graduating. It was the sixth.
Five.
Fifth. It was the fifth, that's what I said, not the sixth. Graduating class. Rabbi Tunick is one of the founding rabbis of the Union for Jewish Universalist Communities, the UJUC. And she's a star in her own right. She does broadcasts on TV on UJUC. In addition, she gives us segments. And she's also a corporate speaker. Okay, there's so much. You have to talk to her later. Don't forget. Ask her who she is. I'll tell you. Rabbi Zisser has taught in schools in New York City until he joined the Solomon Schechter School of Westchester, where he is the king of the Solomon Schechter School in Westchester.
It's a trip, right?
I know it's a trip. And he works as a learning specialist at the High School Center for Academic Support. As a Jewish educator, Rabbi Sandy began his work informally as a counselor at Ramah Nayak, and then more formally working at Hebrew schools over the years. Ask him about him. He's got more.
Class three,
that's what I said. Class three.
About 5 years.
Five years.
So everybody's saying Mazel Tov, hello.
That's great. I'm sorry I have you stand. I got you a little. It's all right. It's almost done. Practical rabbinics, don't get them up early, please. So this Shabbat, we're going to read from the Torah portion, which is called Chukat. It literally means ritual law. And in this portion, Moses is taught the laws of the red heifer, whose ashes will purify a person who has been contaminated by contact with a dead body. Now, this ritual law is known as a chok. I know, I'm not taking your thing. Trust me.
Totally are.
No, I'm not. But you can do it again. I'm just saying. That we are commanded to do, even though there's no rational explanation. Like start an online rabbinical school. Or an online synagogue. It's a chok, what I do. All right, Rabbi Tunick will be sharing a message with you and elaborating on what I just said. Okay, I set you up good. Anyway, right now we're going to join in a meditation from one of my mentors, Rabbi Joseph Gelberman, Zichron Livracha. Rabbi Gelberman was a contemporary He was a contemporary of Rav Zalman Shachter Shlomi, the founder of Jewish Renewal, as I'm sure some of you know here, right? And both rabbis were on a similar path. They both engaged in spiritual enlightenment and were progressive in their thoughts and teachings, particularly around Kabbalah and the interfaith. And it is from Rabbi Gelberman's inspiration that the seeds of JSLI were planted. Rabbi Gelberman was known for his wisdom and humor despite a challenging life. He experienced religious persecution as a child in Hungary, and then again as a young rabbi when his wife and young daughter were taken to Auschwitz by the Nazis. Rabbi Gelberman's greatest gift, perhaps, was that he was early to embrace the idea that although religions are different, the intention is always the same, getting closer to God. And he liked to illustrate his interfaith philosophy this way. Imagine a blackboard, and in the middle of the blackboard are the names of all the religions. We can all imagine that, yes? And over the religions is a big G, meaning God. And when you look at it, you realize at the end of the day, we're all going to the same place. And he would say it just like that. It was very fun. So he would continue, let me help you all to get there. So this evening, I offer you all an opportunity to take a spiritual and emotional journey to freedom right now. Rabbi Gelberman always took great joy in leading this meditation. So everybody, close your eyes and join me in this spiritual mikvah. Hold out your hands to your sides with your palms up. Now feel some drops of heavenly water.
No.
Okay, or not. Hitting your hands. Feel those drops. One, two, three. Now bring your hands and the water to your forehead. And use that water in your hands to wash away any negative thoughts and all your fears and all your doubts. And most importantly, all your judgments. Wipe them away. Now bring that water to your eyes and wash away all the blinders that keep you from seeing your fellow human beings exactly as they are in God's image. Your brothers and your sisters. Now bring that heavenly water to your ears and clear your ears so that you may only hear truth, and that you are able to hear any cries for help and support. And then bring your hands and the water to your mouth so that you may only speak of truth and love and joy. And take that water and spread it all over you, all over your body, your front, your sides, all around, and clean away all the negativity that you've built up. And you know you've built up a lot of negativity. So you can start again, fresh and cleansed and pure in God's eyes. So now, before you open your eyes, and if they're open, close them. Before you open your eyes, I'm going to ask you a very important question. Are you ready? Are you ready to serve the Lord? If you are, say, I am ready.
I am ready.
I am ready.
I am ready.
I am ready to serve the Lord.
I am ready to serve the Lord.
You have a little melody for that. I am ready. Everybody, are you ready?
I am ready.
I am ready to serve the Lord. He wasn't a great melodist, but it was in the intention. The intention was great. So anyway, that is the meditation. Now you can be seated. We're going to continue with the Ve'ahata. All right? I hope you're all renewed now. Actually, the rain is gone. Isn't that
something? It's funny.
There's a rainbow.
And there's just, there you go.
There's a rainbow, everybody.
We helped anyway. It was our energy. So the Ve'ahata, let's do it in the English. All right, on page 32, if you have a little purple siddur. In English, you shall love Adonai, your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. Take to heart these instructions with which I charge you this day. Impress them upon your children. Recite them when you stay at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you get up. Bind them as a sign on your hand, and let them serve as a symbol on your forehead. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Thus you shall remember to observe all my commandments and to be holy to your God. I am Adonai, your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am Adonai, your God. Let's do the Micha Mocha, page 36. Stand again. I know you needed that. Come on. That's going to be on page 130. Page
130, here we go. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Avotenu Imotenu Elohei Abraham Elohei Yitzchak Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah Elohei Rivka Elohei Levya, Elohei Leah, Ha'el HaGadol, HaGibor, V'Hanora, El Elyon, Mel HaSadim, Tovim, V'Konei HaKol, V'Zofer HaSdei Avot, V'Imahot, Baruch Atah Adonai, Ma'in Abraham, Be'etzah Sarah, Atah Gibor Le'olam Adonai, Ha'ei Ha'ol Rav Le'Hoshia, Mechaim, Chesed, Mechaim, So make no flame, no faith, holy, Umatir Asuri, Umekaye, Emunato, Mishele Avai, Mihamoha, Bahagelo, Umidomela, Elekini.
It's in Stony Point, New York. Hi, Rabbi Judy. Hi, I. Lakadal, it's been a long time.
Everyone around the world. Maybe seated. Now I'd like to bring up Rabbi Nancy Tunick to share a few words about a topic of which I'm not sure. Which I have not.
All right, everyone gather in. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
And so this is going to allow you to focus your attention. So I'm going to stay quiet. And it's really challenging for me because I'm a singer and a rabbi. And so we've had such a joyous experience singing. So at least I got to hear my daughter Sarah singing beautifully out there. So we are not actually a tradition that always recognizes everything that is good. We have a habit of complaining. That's sort of standard trope in Jewish film, television, that we complain, right? Including sort of the Woody Allen, Annie Hall joke. There were two elderly women at a Catskills Mountain Resort, and one of them said, "Boy, the food in this place is terrible." The other one says, "I know, such small portions." So our complaining is known in the secular world. Like the Yiddish word, I like the delayed laugh. So if we're complaining about the food, why do we care if it's a small portion? So in Yiddish, that's kvetching, right?
Yeah.
So some say that Jews like to kvetch because it wards off the evil eye. So the thought goes that if you complain enough, the evil eye will assume that you are unhappy. To stay away as the work is done. So I was raised with this concept of the kinahara, right? So a kinahara, if you're not familiar with it, is this idea that through Jewish superstition, that if you say something too good, that the evil eye will rule it. And it's actually Yiddish. It's a contraction of three words, kain, which means not, a ayin, which is I, and hara, being evil. So not the evil eye. So in a practical setting, this meant that if someone said something good about this present situation, we would need to say kinahara. So let's try. Right? Here we are going. So you say, this is going to be such a spiritual, meaningful, beautiful Shabbat week.
Kinahara.
Thank you. Beautiful. And also, apparently you don't like poo-poo because evil spirits also don't like spit. So though the kinahara and kvetching are rooted in superstition in the Middle Ages, the Jewish history of complaining actually originates in Torah, because we just did that during our 40-year journey across the desert from slavery to the promised land. So I call it the journey of oy vey. Right? Oy vey, we were constantly complaining. We didn't have enough food. We complained about Moses leaving and not coming back on time. We complained about our leadership. We complained about the awesomeness of our enemies. And in this week's Parsha alone, Chukat, we complained about the lack of water. We complained about snakes. We complained about a lot. So why were we always complaining? So wasn't it better to be free and have hardships? And to be slaves, where was our gratitude? But here's an interesting thought. We were slaves for hundreds of years. We weren't just slaves for a little while. And when we were freed from bondage, the people who followed Moses out of slavery, they were not only slaves, their parents were slaves, and their grandparents were slaves, and their great-grandparents were slaves, and their great-great-grandparents were slaves for generation after generation. So when you're a slave, are you allowed to complain? Complaining is for those who are free. And when we were slaves, we had to accept every hardship, every task, every punishment, every moment without complaint. So our ancestors had not complained for hundreds of years when we became free and to follow God and Moses across the desert. So at first they sang, "Michmocha, who are you, master of wonders?" But then I imagine as the journey continued and hardships presented themselves, our ancestors realized that they were free and permitted to not only complain, but also to question and examine their actions and the actions and directions of their leaders. So taken in this light, kvetching becomes a privilege rather than annoyance or even a sin. So as you know, we are given directions or commandments or mitzvot by God in Torah in three different forms. So we have mishpatim, laws that we would have likely thought of ourselves. Hopefully we all have instilled in us organically. We're not going to kill anybody, hopefully we're not robbing people. We have a doubt that can be rationally explained when we hear about them. That makes sense, and I'm going to follow that commandment. And we have a name for which this parsha is named. So chukim, there's a commandment that transcends our understanding. We follow it out of sheer faith. So the chukat in this parsha is the purification process that involves burning an unblemished red cow, using the cow's ashes to sprinkle on those who have become unclean after contact with a dead body. It's on the third and seventh day. All right, so this is hard to understand. There is absolutely no way that we would have ever come up with this ourselves. And we're challenged to think, why was this commanded by God? So why are chukim part of mitzvot? In just the same way that complaining and worrying about the evil eye are the luxuries of a free people, commandments from God that we do not understand are the luxury of a people with faith. Chukim are the luxury of a people who are making a transition from slavery to freedom and fear to faith. So if we travel through our journeys without faith, chaos appears to reign. And there will be many times on your journeys as rabbis when you will be faced with people who ask, why did this have to happen? I serve on an advisory board at St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, and you cannot talk with a parent there and not think, why did this have to happen? We hear about senseless violence in the world. We ourselves have personal tragedies. We struggle with illness. We struggle with job situations. We struggle with family. We struggle with tragedy. Nobody in the world genuinely escapes the question, why did this have to happen? And here's the tough reality. At this point in our spiritual development, we do not know the answer to that question. It's like a chukat. It transcends our understanding. But by accepting that our mitzvot include a category of action that requires sheer faith, we are reminded that there are parts of our journey that are exactly the same. So you're beginning a new journey after we celebrate the Shabbat, a journey that will allow you to combine faith and action as Moses and your ancestors did so many years ago. And you will also grow and develop as your ancestors did on their journey. And the questions you ask and the ideas you explore will be different tomorrow than they will be in 5 years or in 15 years. Or in our favorite number, 40 years. But as you embrace the path of the rabbinate, try to remember to enjoy the process of this journey without getting caught up in the result. We are not a reward-based tradition. We do not act to repair the world, to kanolam, to create peace, to get to the promised land, but rather to create the promised land. So each step of the journey that has brought you to this place, welcoming Shabbat with her fellow travelers of JSLY class number 13, it's been significant. And each step of the journey moving forward creates a life as a whole. So not only did you mention the red heifer, but I couldn't help but notice that it was class number 13. That's why I was waving you off.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And now we'd like to kvetch, and we're superstitious about the Ken Hara and the evil eye. The number 13 in Judaism, unlike in secular society, is considered lucky. So I have to repeat, because the most important, well, they're all important, but the key one for this Shabbat is that Ahava and Echad, love and one. They both equal 13. So I wish everyone on the Shabbat, Shabbat, and the blessing of being one with God and one with everyone as you continue on your journey as spiritual leaders, spiritual followers, and now for some of you rabbis shortly. And of course, we should not forget to say, Kenara, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. All right, so it's time to do a Misha Berah for those who are ill. Unfortunately, there's always people who are ill. We have people online, I'm sure.
I don't know. They couldn't really hear Rabbi Nancy. I feel bad that that was
well,
just what happens.
We do the best we can.
I'm going to move this over here.
So we'll probably, we might as well do the
See if they can hear better. A bunch here.
Yeah, read
them
fast.
Let's see. Sid and Joyce, Dolores, Arlene, John Bazzano, Rabbi Zisser, Shabbat Shalom for me, Lois Dar, Ann Moser, Betty Galloway, Cliff, Janet, Marlene, Amber, Donna, Dakota, Dylan and Bob, Lisa and Richard, Rabbi Nancy, Rabbi Janie. Oh, wait. Juana Suero. Let me see. Hold on. Okay, Juana Suero. Bronx Lebanon Hospital. I'm not sure what that is. Lee Sharp and Leo and Joanne. Marie, Alan, Fred, Cindy, John Jacobson, Jill, and Jeff Forbes. Lebanon Hospital today. Amen.
Here's Roger Moore's cottage. And tonight we were there was a tragedy in the hospital in Manhattan. Was a policeman killed or something?
I know a bunch of people, it looks like. Rabbi Karen was born at that hospital.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Bronx, Lebanon.
A hospital in New York that was crazy people.
That was an ex-doctor.
An ex-doctor did?
Mm-hmm. Shot and killed people, including himself.
Yigadal, Yigadash,
Shmei Rabba.
The Almighty brought you today, Yadlikon today. V'chayechom, V'yomechom, V'chayech, V'chol Beit Yisrael. V'agala, V'yisman, Kariv, V'imru, Amen. Yehei, Shmei Rabba, V'barach, V'yolam, V'lamei, Omaya. Yidvorach, v'yishabach, v'yitha'ar, v'yitromach, v'yitnaseh, v'yitadar, v'yitaleh, v'yitalach, shmei kusha, reichu. Le'ela, v'yitkol, birchata, v'shirata, tushbihata, v'nehemata, da'miram, v'yalma, v'imru, amen. Yehei, shlamam, rabam, v'yitshemaya, v'chayim, alim, v'yal kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Oseh shalom b'romah, hu yaseh shalom, aleinu yakol Yisrael, yakol yoshvei tevel, v'imru, amen. Please be seated. And now announcements. So announcements are, services will be, well first of all, after this, now we're ending, we're going back to our abode. Where there's wine and
What else? That's it, right? Wine and pretzels, maybe.
Good potato, popcorn.
Popcorn. Wow. Wine and pretzels. What's better than that?
And candy.
Well, that could be better. And then tomorrow morning we dive in at 8:45. Breakfast is at 8.
I'll have to look.
It's probably 8. Yeah.
Thank you.
So you know the drill now. When you go over there, it's easy. Right. What else? So Shabbos dread, like what you're doing. It's fine. What else? What else do we need to know? That's it. And then after services, we're gonna read through papers. And then we're gonna go swimming in the pool. Oh, there's no pool. So sorry. And then before you know it, it'll be time for Marav and ordination. It goes very fast. Very fun. Anyway, that's it. So let's sing something. I know. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for us. God bless you all on your journeys through tomorrow and next week. Be healthy, we have good times, be happy, smile, don't talk politics, let it go. Don't do anything for you. God bless you. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. Amen. Say hi to your peeps. Say hi to your peeps. I haven't turned it off.
People.
Yeah, they are.
Oh,
say hi to
people.
Them.
I missed you. Where was my glasses?
Here, you can use mine. Okay.
I gotta say goodbye. Guys.
Yeah, say goodbye.
I love you all. I'll see you later. We'll see you next week. Okay, let's see. You gotta shut them off?
Mm-hmm.
Are they good?
Yeah. Okay. That's you just push them.